Hey guys, and welcome back to my world. So today I've got another very, very quick video for you. I had a question on Twitter, how to actually create self-refilling chests. Now the user wanted to actually create a chest that every time you open up the chest and you remove some of the contents, that the chest actually just keeps on refilling itself automatically. Okay, now this is very useful in certain cases, like this user, for example, wanted to have a mini game books that just shows you how to play the game, and every time that you open up the chest is filled. So so let me show you very, very quick and easy how that is done. Okay, so basically you'll see, first of all, I'm using a trapped chest. Now the nice thing about a trapped chest is that when you open it up, it then acts as a power source. Okay, so you'll see it'll then activate, it'll turn this block into like, push the signal into this block and then actually activate that redstone over there. So if we take this away and I open up the chest, you will see that that redstone is now active. Okay, so every time I open the chest, it activates that redstone. So what I've done is I've basically just inverted the signal, meaning that then when this block is actually powered, it will turn off this torch, okay, which will then turn off that redstone dust, which will then not activate that command block. So when I open up the chest, you'll see that that redstone dust at the bottom is no longer active. When the chest closes, okay, the torch goes back on, because this block is no longer powered. The torch goes back on, which then powers that redstone dust, which then powers this one command block. And all that this command block does, it clones a chest from a certain location right up to here. Now that location can be anywhere. I just happen to put it here so that we can very, very easily show you how this works. If I just add redstone to the bottom of this, okay. So the next time I open up this thing, and I close it and open it up again, you'll see the redstone. So basically when I open it up, signal goes off. When the chest closes, this command block clones this chest to over here. Now this is absolutely great, because at any time, as you saw, I can come in and I can make changes. So let's just say I actually want to add these as well. Okay, so any time I can go in and I can make changes. Okay, so that is the one method of doing it. Very, very simple, very, very basic, and very, very small. Very, very small form factor. Now, another thing you can do, if you want to use a normal chest, is that a normal chest actually outputs a signal when there's items in it. So if I put a comparator over here, okay, you'll see it's lit up because there's items in the chest. If I take the items out, I've already activated this. Hold on, let me just... When I take the items out, okay, you will see that the comparator is off. Okay, so it doesn't power it. So, but unfortunately, as you can see, it doesn't power it downwards. I can only power it to the sides and to blocks touching it. Okay, so if I were to encase this like this, it'll power through one block. Okay, right. So if I put something in there, you'll see it'll power through one block. Okay, it will not power through two blocks. Okay, it will not do that. You'll see that's off, but that one is on. So this is handy if you've got your chest against a wall and you don't want the player to see that it is a trap chest. Okay, so I'm going to do exactly the same. When there's items in there, I'm going to output a signal. I'm going to invert the signal. So when this block is powered, this torch is off. So when I remove the items from this chest, okay, it will then actually no longer output a signal. Okay, but I've output a signal, it'll turn this torch on, and this is another clone command that just clones that chest to over here. Now I can once again put anything in this chest. So if I want to just do that, the next time I empty this chest, you'll see that it'll clone that one in here. So this is handy to replace a chest when it is empty, and this one is handy to replace a chest every single time it is closed. Okay, cool. So that's really the two main methods that I think would work quite well for whatever solution you want. The danger of this chest over here is that I might actually leave something in there and it won't reset, but that, I mean, that has its kind of uses as well. Cool, guys, so that's very basic, very, very quick, and a very, very nice, easy way to do that. I mean, you can have a random something running that just randomly sets this chest as something new, so that every single time that you open up the chest, it is like something new. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching, and as always, a like, a comment, and a subscribe is much appreciated, and please feel free to share. Guys, thank you very much for watching, and as always, I will check you all later.